Hi, everybody. Welcome to Demo, the show where companies come in and show us their latest products and platforms. Today, I'm joined by Emilee Tellez. She is a field CTO at Veeam Software. Welcome to the show, Emilee.
Thank you, Keith. I'm happy to be here.
Congratulations. You're our first virtual demo.
That's awesome.
So what are you showing us today for the episode?
Absolutely. So today we're going to be discussing everything that's part of the Veeam Data Platform Premium.
Okay. And, who is this designed for usually within an enterprise? You're allowed to say everybody, but more specifically, is there a role within a company, you know, who benefits most from this product?
Sure. So I'll say it is for everybody, but when we start thinking about specific cyber attacks or threats that companies can face, CISOs and security analysts, they're going to love Veeam Data Platform Premium because it can help them in their defense and response capabilities. And then when we think about the CIO and IT ops, it helps them to highlight any gaps in their recovery process.
Right. And the idea is that you're merging the world of the security teams with the IT operations teams, right? It still feels like a lot of companies, those are separate groups that don't communicate a lot, or there's things that get thrown over the wall, so to speak, right?
Absolutely. Yep. We want to make sure that we can bring those two teams together so that way they could have a better response when it comes to any type of incident or threat that may occur.
All right. And so, what are some of the main problems here that you're solving with this? Like, why should companies really do this? Does it make it more effective than what they're doing now? Or what would they be doing if they didn't have this platform?
Sure. So generally speaking, when we start thinking about Veeam, or we start thinking about your recovery process after a cyber event has occurred, recovery is going to be your number one currency. So everyone should be backing up their data. That's table stakes. But when it comes to being able to have breadth and depth of different recovery features and functionality to restore your data where you see fit, that's where it really comes to highlight where organizations can, you know, increase their cyber resiliency posture, be able to have full flexibility and access to their data, how they want it, when they want it.
All right. So let's jump into the demo. Show me a couple of the cool features that you have with the Veeam Data Platform.
Perfect. So we want to go ahead and take an opportunity to talk about the Veeam difference. So let's take, for an example, attack from a ransomware group like Akira. And if we were to look at a company without Veeam, specifically a threat actor that gained access into the environment, there's no notification. Maybe there's no initial access for them being able to determine how did they get in. Companies with Veeam, they have the opportunity to detect brute force login attempts from within vSphere, as well as see any potential unusual behavior on specific VMDKs.
Okay.
So when we look at our Veeam One analytics and monitoring platform, it has so many robust alarms that come fully featured within our product. So I can set alarms to report on my vSphere environment, my Hyper-V environment, my actual backup and replication environment, as well as even protecting items within M365. But the one thing that we want to showcase in here is this possible ransomware activity. So this is running on the actual virtual machine itself. So within production, not before a backup occurs, but when those virtual machines actually get attached. So we can see in here, we have some rules that we can set that could be predefined, right? We could have them be based off of specific and or logic that would trigger this event to say that we see something suspicious or anomalous happening here. We can assign that to certain workloads, as well as notify our security administrator so that way they could take a deeper look. We have some actions in here as well. So we could disable that virtual machine to the network. We can make that happen automatically or with some approval ratings. And then there's an opportunity in here for them to be able to see what is this alarm actually doing? And is there custom roles or sets or pieces in here that we want to have be fully included as part of this alarm, specifically tailored to your environment?
Now, are these settings done so that your security team doesn't get a sense of either alarm fatigue or a bunch of false positives that would then end up, you know, they would end up ignoring these alarms because they get so many of them?
Correct.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
That is exactly it.
Okay.
So then let's take a look at a next item, right? So when we think about threat actors gaining access and then them moving laterally within an environment, how do we further notify an organization of this potential threat actor lurking in the environment. So customers with Veeam, not only can we see data that's happening on the actual production machines itself, but we know for a fact threat actors, their first point of what they're going to go after is generally speaking your backups, because they want to ensure that they're going to have a payday. So if they can mess with, corrupt, delete, anything like that, that's what they're going to go and target.
Okay.
So from Veeam, we have a way that we can actually scan those endpoints or scan those backup servers and ensure that if there's anomalous activity that's happening on those, for example, if we wanted to take a look at some critical or even just some high events inside of here, I can actually see, okay, there's some brute force login attempts. So somebody's actively trying to gain access into these machines or into this backup server. Or if I wanted to take a look at something that's even higher of a criticality, right? I could see if there's malware detection events that have actually been flagged from the software itself.
Wow.
So we found encryption or some tools that can be utilized for exfiltration that can all be highlighted here as a proactive assessment.
Wow. I didn't even realize that a lot of the attacks go after the backup servers because they're, because they realize that, like, well, if you just attack and try to grab the data, companies have backup. So let's go after the backup before we start stealing the data. Is that the reason that you're seeing that?
Yeah. No, absolutely.
Yeah.
So we have a ransomware trends report that we do every year. And inside of that, the 1,200 organizations that were impacted from this report actually responded that 96% of the time they saw that threat group go directly after their backups and try to corrupt, delete, do whatever they can to make it harder for them to be able to recover.
Right. Okay. So the next step then is, here it is.
So yeah, let's say the threat actor got in, right? And they start performing encryption or exfiltration attempts on the data itself. So Veeam made some really big strides within the past 2 years to include more security scanning capabilities within our product alone to help customers to identify when they have a clean state or a clean recovery point to be able to go back to. So when we look at it ourselves, right, in our malware detection, we could look at things like encryption detection. So is there changes or mass amount of changes within the production data that we can capture when we're doing the backups inline? So as we're processing the backups, we're seeing those large change amounts. File detection, being able to look for suspicious files like onion links or even attack techniques that we should monitor, like, you know, are they using things like mini cats, or is there also some additional tools out there that threat actors are using to perform exfiltration attempts? Or if the company has a whitelist policy to say we shouldn't be using things like FileZilla within our production machines itself, Veeam can actually pick that up as part of that inline scanning process and see that these tools exist on their production machines that maybe they shouldn't be. So how can we alert security teams to those potential threats?
Okay.
Signature detection as well. So it's not just about looking at those potential threats, but also from an AV provider standpoint, right? So how can we look at different malware that even has polymorphic capabilities, or if a customer already invested in their AV tool, that they can leverage that as well to do scanning of the backups as well. So we offer both options for customers to take advantage of. And then they can also integrate with their third-party security tools, have that tool trigger an out-of-band backup in the event they're experiencing an encryption attempt on their machines itself.
Right.
And I'll show you an example here. So this is what it looks like when we actually identify any of those malware detection settings in here. So an item is seen as suspicious because we found an onion link, or it's seen as infected because we found external or a known malware extension, or we are able to run a Yara scan and identify those indicators of compromise as part of that data set.
Okay. All right. And so we're going to assume that the attack is still going on for companies that don't have Veeam. Should I assume that by at this point, if the company does have Veeam, that they would be able to stop the attempt? Or is it more of like that they're just monitoring it as it's going on, and or preventing it from getting worse, right?
Yep, exactly. So they should be able to start, you know, going into a process of stopping the attempt from happening, right? So being able to trigger out a band backup so that way they can capture as much data as possible before it becomes corrupted or encrypted, being able to flag their security teams and highlight a potential threat that's happening within their environment. But I like to say it as a triage event specifically.
Okay.
Threat actors already inside of your environment, they're already creating a muck of everything within your environment, right? So how do we help you from a recovery process after that incident to ensure that you're not reinfecting yourself for a second or a third time?
Okay.
And that starts with giving them that capability to see into clean data and validated data.
Okay.
The second to last part in here is incident response, right? So let's say now you are going through this actual full-blown ransomware attack, and now we have to engage with an incident response vendor to help us with understanding who this threat group is, you know, what exactly did they gain access to? How do we confirm exfiltration? The one thing about Veeam is we actually acquired a company called Coveware last year that specializes in incident response, and they have a large threat actor database where they're able to aggregate a lot of this data and provide it back to organizations that are wanting to learn more about who it is that they're dealing with from a specific ransomware group.
Right.
How do they negotiate, things of that nature. So we have people on hand that deal with this on a day-to-day process that can actually help customers to ensure that they are taking the right steps during this incident.
Okay.
And then last but not least is recovery, right? Recovery, like I mentioned before, it's going to be your currency. So being able to have full flexibility for that recovery process is crucial. So once you see something like significant material damage has been done, or if you can't recover data back because you have to recover it back to the original location, or if you're now having to, you know, lean on support for getting new equipment or going to a hypervisor, whatever it may be, the nice thing about Veeam is we focus on data portability. So how can we make sure that you have minimal material damage after the event has occurred, giving you full flexibility of performing the restore.
Yep.
But then on top of that, I know all my risk and compliance officers are going to love this, making it fully documented, right?
Wow.
So how can I make sure that when in a true cyber recovery fashion where I need to recover massively at scale, how do I document this entire process and validate that where I'm going to be recovering to is actually going to work? So you could see here, this is a full document that's been generated by Veeam and essentially has in my plan my tier one virtual machines, my databases that need to be spun up at my new location. It validates that the recovery point objectives as well as the recovery time objectives are being met. SLAs from the business can be validated. On top of that, it checks to see from a malware scan perspective, are those restore points valid? Do we have any symptoms of anomalous activity on there that we don't want to recover? So we go through a full documented process, highlights all the virtual machines that are associated, shows that they're in a ready state, and organizations can trust knowing that their documented cyber incident response plan is always going to be up to date, ready to go, and they can trigger this at a moment's notice to start doing a massive restore or failover to a secondary site, or even to something like the cloud. We do support being able to take this data and recover it into Microsoft Azure as well. So if they need to do that, they can.
Yeah. What I like about this entire process and this platform is that there's not an assumption that for companies like that you're not promising like we're going to stop everything, but rather like we're going to help you throughout the entire process so that it's almost like, you know, companies understand that security is not 100%, correct? And so it's more now about helping them through the process to stop it and then get it recovered as quickly as possible. And that seems to be more of the benefit than just trying to say right at the start, like, we'll just prevent everything from happening. Because I think most people realize that is almost impossible, right?
In security worlds, they talk about defense in depth strategies, right? So how can they have multiple layers that can stop a threat actor before they actually gain access into the full systems, right? And they're at the point of negotiation. I like to think of it defense and response. So how can we offer customers and organizations the ability to respond in multiple different ways that can be tailored to their organization and help them improve any processes that they have to have or that they are regulated to, so that way they can have a full incident response plan that's actually tailored towards them. And last but not least, right? So the one thing that I do want to point out is even though Veeam has integrated all these great security partnerships into our product, we are strictly working on, you know, having more integrated opportunities with different security vendors out there. So when I talk to my security teams that are leveraging CrowdStrike, Palo Alto, Sophos, they can have full integrations and being able to take the data set that Veeam is able to pull in and point it to their different platforms. So that way security analysts can get that information in the dashboard in the actual product that they leverage, so that way they don't have to go out and learn something brand new.
Right.
So that information can be free flowing.
Yeah, I think before the show we talked about all of the integrations that you have, and that's always a great thing because there's a lot of security companies out there. So it's nice to not have to feel like that they have to learn something brand new and get rid of the other things that they can still integrate with what they've already got.
Absolutely.
So you've got a lot of great features there, Emilee, you know, but I'm sure you've got a lot of other features. So where can people go for more information? And do you offer a free trial or a demo period that where people can try this out, you know, before they buy it?
Yes, we do. So they could just go to the Veeam website, so veeam.com. They could download a full trial there and they could test out all the wonderful capabilities that the Veeam Data Platform has to offer. And so that is available to them for a trial day period.
All right. Emilee Tellez from Veeam Software. Thanks again for being on the show and thanks for the demo.
Yeah, thank you.
That's all the time we have for today's episode. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, add any thoughts you have below. Join us every week for new episodes of Demo. I'm Keith Shaw. Thanks for watching.